Hello and welcome to another episode of Speed. Short, powerful episodes of enthusiasm and determination. Thanks for listening in. It's fabulous to know that you are there. Today we're reading a story called Some Just Can't See It. And here we go. Sometimes even an accomplished leader with a compelling vision has trouble getting everyone to buy into his dreams. That was true in the early 1950s when a friend of television pioneer Ark Linkletter tried to convince him to buy some land. His buddy, a movie executive who had been a close family friend for years, drove him out into the country to look at some property. After driving for more than 25 miles, they turned off the main road and drove through fields and groves of trees. There wasn't a person for miles. They saw grazing horses and the occasional abandoned shed. Art's friend began explaining his next bold venture, an amusement park, unlike anything the world had ever seen. It would have its own little world. It would contain areas with names like Fantasyland and Tomorrowland. Art's friend said it would be called Disneyland. Art Linkletter thought his friend Walt Disney was crazy. Who in the world is going to drive 25 miles to ride a roller coaster? He thought to himself. I had admiration for his business acumen and his show business savvy, and I hardly knew how to tell him that I thought he was making the biggest mistake of his entire life. After painting a verbal picture of his vision, Disney said to Linklater, Art, financially I can handle only Disneyland itself. It will take everything that I have. But the land bordering on it that we're standing on now will be jammed with hotels and motels and restaurants and convention halls to accommodate the people who will come to and spend their entire vacations at my parks. I've bought all I can afford. I want you to have the opportunity to get some of the surrounding acreage that will increase in value several hundred times in the next 5 years. Walt Disney had no agenda with his friend other than to add value to him. He wanted to share an opportunity, but Linkletter just couldn't see it. He made excuses and said he would look into it later. Later will be too late, said Disney. You better move. Disney was right, of course, and Linkletter never forgot his walk back to the car that day, because later he figured it probably cost him $1 million per step. Art Linkletter and Walt Disney never let this incident get in the way of their friendship. They remain close up until Walt's death. As you seek to enlist people into the fulfillment of your vision, don't be discouraged when people can't see what you do. And don't despair if people you respect won't take the trip with you, even after you've invited them. Celebrate when people choose to join you and keep loving those who don't. Now there's a story for you. That was from this book called Journey to Success by John Maxwell, from Success to Significance, in fact. Hope you enjoyed that. I appreciate you listening. Have a fabulous day. Bye-bye.